So, are you born again? No.
She will tell you what it is.
Are you born again? No. Do you know what it means? No.
The most of the world.
So, I'm going to preach the gospel to you. You believe in heaven?
Yeah.
Yeah. And if you die today, do you think you're going to go to heaven?
If you, yeah.
You do, yeah? You?
Probably not.
Right?
But you want to?
Yeah.
It's that simple. Take it, what he's going to offer.
Why? Why are you not going to go to heaven?
I don't know.
You don't know. Well, we can do a quick test to see if you can go to heaven. Dead easy. So how many lies have you told in life?
Thousands.
How many have you told?
Thousands.
So what would you call someone who tells lies?
A liar.
So what are you two?
Liars.
Yep. As we all are, because we've all lied. Mm-hmm. Have you ever stolen out of your life?
Yeah.
Yes. So what do you call someone who steals?
It's a dealer.
Thieves. So what are you? So what are all of us in this room?
Thieves.
Liars.
Have you ever used God's name in vain? Oh my God, Jesus Christ, I swear with.
A couple of times by accident.
By accident. You did it. That's called blasphemy.
Yes.
It's a very serious offence. So we won't go no further than that. We could go further, but we won't go further, because that's far enough. So by your own admission, you're lying, thieving, blasphemers. Mm-hmm. If you die today as lying, thieving, blasphemers, you stand before God, who's a holy, righteous judge, and he should judge you on them crimes, would you be innocent or guilty?
Guilty.
So heaven or hell?
Heaven.
No, hell, definitely, not probably. Definitely hell. Mm-hmm. But you know what God has done for guilty, wicked sinners like us, so we have to go to hell? You know?
Uh-huh.
You know what God has done for guilty, wicked, sinful people like us in this room, so we have to go to hell?
It's forgiveness.
No. Do you know what he's done? Yes. So Christ has died on that cross, came into this world, God became a man, walked in this earth, came with us, lived a spotless life, never lied, never stole, never did anything wrong. Because the only way someone could pay for us has to be an innocent for a guilty. We can't have a guilty for guilty. So an innocent person stood in the place of guilty people, and he took the punishment on him so we can be forgiven, and we don't have to be punished now. You don't have to go to hell no more. Because the hell, Jesus took hell for you. He took it. And so now you can have mercy and forgiveness. But do you know what you have to do? Do you know?
Repent.
You have to repent and get baptized for the remission of your sin. And you will receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. And God will deliver you from look at how your mum used to be. Have you seen a change in your mum?
Yeah.
A massive change, innit? And so this is what happened on you, yeah? Because the thing is, we can't be good on our own. We cannot do it on our own strength, yeah? You can try, but you will fail. And even as Christians, we still fail. But God is with us and he helps us. But if you turn to God now, and you repent and get baptized, and get delivered from anything that's working against you, it'll be so much easier to follow God, you know what I mean? And then you'll be on what's called the narrow path, yeah, which is the path that leads to heaven. Because broad is the way that leads to destruction. And there are many that go that way, but narrow is the way that leads to life. And there'll be few that find it. And so if you want to get on the narrow path and get serious with God, because when are you going to die, do you know?
No.
For the truth.
Because do you know what?
It's now, maybe tomorrow.
150,000 people die every single day. Mm-hmm. And they're all planning for next week. And it includes 10-year-olds, and it includes 15-year-olds, and 14-year-olds, and babies, and it includes 80-year-olds. Yeah. And so at any age, at any time, you can die in this world. You could go out tomorrow, and if you get run over by a bus, you could be dead. And so you need to really, the Bible says today is the day of salvation, yeah? And you need to get serious with God. And when you do that, yeah, it's not like it's a hard life of, you know, being goody, goody, goody and trying to keep all these rules. It's not that. It's God changes you from the inside out. And you don't even want to do them bad things anymore. And you look back at the bad things you used to do and you think, as if I used to do that. And you'll think, as if I ever got cheeky with my mom. You'll say, as if I ever got cheeky with my mom. As how did I dare do that? How did I dare speak to my mum? And you'd be like, Mum, I'm so sorry, please forgive me. Mum, I'm like, it's alright. It's alright. So the question is, you know, it's like, you can pray for you, but the reason why your mum got delivered is because your mum's heart was for God.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? But you can pray for someone whose heart's not for God, and you can get the demons out, but guess what? You go back to your old ways, then demons come back. So it's like, it's not like deliverance is a quick fix. It's not, yeah? It's salvation.
Sure.
And your mum got saved that day, you know, it was a powerful deliverance. You got healed. If it weren't for that, God stepping in, she might be dead now with that mouth cancer, or on her way to dying.
Oh,
wait, because she got healed from mouth cancer at the same time, wasn't it?
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord.
So they said to me, I went to the hospital, they said it looks like cancer size, and then I went to the doctors and said, yeah, I'm going to refer you.
But now you understand the gospel. Now you understand you're a hellbound sinner, don't you? And you understand you're going to go to hell if you die. But the question is, do you want to be forgiven of your sins?
Yeah.
Do you seriously want to be forgiven? Or are you just saying that?
No.
Right, so do you want to pray now? And we're going to ask God to forgive you right now.
Yeah.
Right, stand up. Mom, come on.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Power in the name of Jesus.
All that pain is leaving right now. All that pain is leaving.
Power in the name of Jesus.
Jesus, daughter of the King.
Beautiful daughter of God.
Come on. Thank
you, Jesus.
You are loved with an everlasting love, and even the hairs of your head are numbered. In Jesus' name, every dark demonic spirit working against this beautiful, precious daughter of yours, leave now. Fill them up, God. What's happening?
Praise the living God.
You just felt the warmth. What happened with you there?
Overwhelming love.
The disease is gone now?
Yeah.
And you've felt some healing going on, yeah?
Praise God.
This is only the beginning.
It's only the beginning.
You need to get baptized. Do you want to get baptized?
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah, you do.
Yes.
Do you want to?
Come
the
on.
Bible says you have to repent and be baptized for the remission of your sins.
Yes.
Mum's going to baptize you.
Come on! Hallelujah!
Begin to walk with God.
Power of the
and
living God.
This is
God.
The day that you want to remember. Today is the day of salvation.
This is the day, right?
Where you're going to begin to change. And you're going to start walking with God from this day forward, right?
Mm-hmm.
And this is it's a process, right? You're not going to become instantly perfect.
Mm-hmm.
It's called the sanctification process.
Mm.
And it takes time.
Mm.
But do you know what?
Yes.
God is so patient with us.
Beautiful.
He loves us. He gives
yes.
us time. But all we have to do is just keep going with God. And the devil will try to stop you and say, oh, I don't believe that, da-da-da-da-da. Say, jog on, devil.
Amen.
Amen.
So, have you got stuff to get baptised in?
No.
Right, so can we get them some stuff, darling, so they can get baptised in? Quickly,
no.
Quickly.
No.
Right,
thank
I'm going to fill the bathroom
you
now. Okay. Mom, you're going to
come on. Come on, sister. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. Praise the living God.
This is mother. This is
yes.
mother.
Yes.
Mother's here.
Yes.
Baptising children.
Yes.
So, Gemma.
Yes.
Ask her.
Continue.
Jesus Christ.
Do you believe that he died for your sin?
We'll see.
Yeah,
we'll see.
You're
going to
follow him?
Are you going to follow him?
The
rest
of your life?
And every day?
And turn away from all your sin?
And turn away from all the sin.
Yeah, go on then. Right. On the confession of her own faith.
Confession of your own faith?
Yeah, on the confession of your own faith, your mum's going to baptise you now. Hold her nose, fully under. Fully under, all under, right under. Praise God. Praise God. Anyway, pray more when she gets out.
Hallelujah!
Yes.
Oh.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
You believe Jesus is the Son of God?
Do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God?
Yes.
And died on the cross for your sin?
Yes.
Do you want to repent of all your sins?
Yeah.
Do you want to follow him every day and that from now on be a part of Jesus, no matter what?
Yeah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hold on, Oz. In Jesus' name, back down.
How am I on?
What? Right, on, down you go. Right in, fully in.
Die with Christ. Oh. Christ with Christ.
Oh. Holy Spirit, fill up. Now, in Jesus' name, shout out to God. Hallelujah.
Congratulations. Happy birthday to both sisters.
Well done, sisters. Well done.
Bless you, Kevin Hunter.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus, for new life. Happy birthday, both of you.
These two's relationship is going to grow stronger together. These two are going to love each other more and more, and these two are going to be solid for each other. And you will always be there watching over each other. And all your
congratulations.
Family. No more brokenness in
you
his
see
family.
This house?
God is going to restore it.
This is the house of love and truth.
No more brokenness.
My action is happening
from
heaven.
In Jesus' name.
I love this family.
Prophesy over you. You will be healed.
Truth as you can see.
You are healed in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Sorry. Lord, I repent from saying you will
Jesus.
Be healed. You are healed in Jesus' name.
Yes.
By
his wounds.
Stripes,
yes.
You
yes.
are healed.
Yes.
Yes and amen.
Shut the door.
Yes.
Come on.
Every mocking spirit, lying spirit, depression, oppression, up and out in Jesus' name.
All that pain that's been bottled up for so long, let it go. Let it go. Let it out.
Holy fire. Holy freedom in Jesus' name.
Yes. Hallelujah!
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on!
Amen.